I just got to ask, first of all, we've been talking so much about investor confidence. Facebook, paramount to that story over the last few weeks here. How have you at TD Ameritrade been impacted by the Facebook IPO?
Well, obviously, it was a big IPO, the biggest in a long time. In fact, and there's a lot of excitement. So initially, there was a lot of excitement on over the Facebook IPO, a lot of retail investor demand. And we had that. And that particular day that we did go public was a big trading day for us. It wasn't one of our top 10 trading days, but it was a good trading day, a very big trading day. And it was 22% of our trades on that day. So huge interest. Unfortunately, it hasn't worked out quite the way I think most a retail investor would have hoped. There's a lot of issues with it. And since then, I think it's just one of those things that adds to the flash crash and the crisis and the JP Morgan situation that basically all serves to basically just undermine the confidence of the retail investor.
Now, overall, when we talk about what NASDAQ has put in place, their proposal for about $40 million worth of cash and rebate, trading rebates for brokerages that were impacted by the Facebook IPO, are you going to be participating in that program?
Yes and no. I mean, from our point of view, we were ahead of the curve on this IPO. We knew it was coming. We knew it was going to be big based on the demand. And so we were very much all over it on the day that it happened. So unfortunately, or fortunately for us, our market makers were very responsible that day. So all of our clients knew where they stood at that Friday, at the end of the day. And they turned around and made our clients whole based on what they did, and we manually went in and corrected the if they canceled. And so people, that's not to say there aren't a few people that are you know, perfectly happy. It's also to say they don't feel good about what happened. They don't, but I think this is mainly between the NASDAQ and the market makers, at least from our perspective.
Now, Fred, one of the big things about your particular business, you're a great proxy for the retail investor out there. So we talk about Facebook and we talk about the idea that there are now views that you can take on the negative side for Facebook, namely shorting shares, namely buying put options, downside options on it. Have you seen a pickup in that kind of activity? Is there now demand from your clients to borrow those shares and sell them short?
Yes, I think that is definitely going on. What we see, probably the most obvious one, is since the options have been introduced on Facebook, they've been in the top 10 options traded on our platform. And so we're definitely seeing people very interested in Facebook, both on the equity side and the option side.
Now, when we talk about Facebook, really it comes down to investor confidence. What do you think is the single biggest detriment for investor confidence right now?
I think it's the general malaise in the market. I think if you I think if you go through it, it's just the series or the continuation of another issue. We had the crisis. We've had, 3 years in a row where things pick up in the spring and then they fall off in May and June. We've gone from crisis to crisis in Europe. The May jobs report, and you go back, you have the flash crash, the JP Morgan incident, and now the Facebook IPO. When you add it all up, it's a lot of uncertainty and fear about just the integrity of the markets.